I am standing in front of my solar panels. I will give you the details of the solar system I installed for my home. I have installed 6 solar panels. This is a 6 kilowatt solar system. In the future, I will upgrade them to 12 panels. The tilt angle of these solar panels is 34 degrees, according to the area where I am located. The face of the panels is on the north side. And they are working perfectly. I will show you on the inverter its performance as well. I have used a special technique to fit them. I have made it leak-proof. I have installed them temporarily over here. Because I am having a little issue, as I am using electricity through the solar system, you can see this wall in front of my home. Due to this, in the morning time, the sun from the east does not shine in the morning time on the solar panel. Because my solar panels are installed lower than the wall, that is the reason the sun shines late on the panels, due to which low electricity is produced at this period of time. I will upgrade them in the future. Let me show you the other issue. You can see this is the water tank of our home. The solar panels are lower than this too, as I have this area of my roof where I had installed these solar panels. The other problem, this wall of my house. This makes the sunlight not shine on my solar panels in the evening. After 4 o'clock, the performance of my solar panels has gone down. Because half of the solar panels have light not shining. You can see no light is shining on these panels. Let me tell you that too, I've also benefited through the solar system. I have seen a big difference in my bill after installing this green energy. The electricity bill is 60% lower than before. It has almost been 1 month since I am using this solar system. Now let me tell you about its fitting. I have used these galvanized angles which are bent on the machine. If you want to install these for your solar panels, then waterproof it. If you make a hole in your roof, and you install the pipe anchor bolts in it, if you install those bolts directly without waterproofing. Because when it rains, the water will go inside the roof, which could damage the roof. When it rains, the water stays on this area of the roof. Let me show you what technique I used. As I have installed the anchor bolts, you can see I have used silicone with it. I have used silicone a lot to waterproof the roof. When I was installing the stand, I put a lot of silicone inside the hole to not let a single drop of water go inside the roof. This is how I solved the issue of water leaking from the roof. A few days ago it had rained, but water did not leak from the roof. I am telling this technique for that area where it rains a lot. As I told you, I will upgrade this system. It gives me peak performance at midday time. I have used Canadian solar panels, which are made in China. The maximum power of each panel is 420 watts. The optimum operating voltages are 40.8 volts. The optimum operating current is 10.3 amperes. The open circuit voltages are 49.2 volts. The short circuit current is 10.96 volts. Max system voltages are 1000 volts and the maximum series fuse rating is 20 amperes. It is a quite good solar panel. Other than this, I have connected all the wires in series. The positive of one panel with the other panel's negative. And the negative with the other positive. And this way, I took the wire connection downwards to the inverter. I have used a 10mm wire, which is easily available in the market. I have covered the wires in a flexible rubber water pipe, as the other pipe gets bent quickly. It does not go bad quickly, that is why I used it. I have used pipe on the other side of the pipe till the solar inverter. Now let's talk about the inverter system and the batteries I have used. I have installed 4 batteries with the system. These are deep cycle batteries which the company claims. The model of the battery is DIB260 of Daewoo company. It is a 12 volt and 20 ampere hour battery. The inverter I have used is a 6 kilowatt from Frontis company. You can see its model name is Infineon plus 6 kilowatts. The color is azure and black. The operating temperature range is 10 to 60 degrees. It is designed in Taiwan. Let me tell you the input from the PV. The operating voltages of the inverter are 360 volts DC. Its Vmax PV is 550 volts DC. The PV input voltages range is 120 to 500 volts DC. The max current from PV it could bear is 25 amps. Other than this, you can explore its specifications yourself. The time right now is 5 o'clock afternoon, and the sun is going to set. As I told you, at this time the performance goes down. We are just getting 1 watt from the solar panels. We are using 1.4 kilowatts right now. The battery is charging at 6 amperes. It is distributing the load to the home from the grid. Other than this, the electric board I have installed will also be upgraded, as it had a little problem with it. You can see the new items have arrived and I will fit them too. I have installed a breaker with the system, which is an AC breaker. It should not be installed here, but what happened was that I brought this DC breaker which was bad. So temporarily, I installed this breaker for the batteries. I have brought a new breaker, which I will install soon with it. The other DC breaker I have installed for the panels, which is 63 amperes. I have used it to protect the voltages flowing from the panels in case any problem arises. This Hager breaker is used for the output of the home. The inverter is passing 218 AC volts as output. I have installed this changeover switch. In case of maintenance, I could directly use the electricity from the grid. I have installed these indicating lights. This green light indicates the electricity is flowing from the PV. This yellow light will not work when I turn off this breaker. This red light is indicating the electricity is flowing from the grid. I have installed this 63 amperes breaker with the main supply of the home. I have used the plastic electric pipes to cover the wires. I have hidden all the wires inside the duct. I have spent above $2,000 till now on this system right now. And I hope this was an informative video for you. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.